yeah, my favorite part of the day is when I get to talk with you. I'm John Zidar, I'm the host of On Top and Hot, and this is February 8th, it is Wednesday, which means I go live tomorrow. Me and Lily Star every Thursday, 4 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, so when you hear that market bell go off, me and Lily Star are going live. We go on YouTube for about an hour talking to our viewers about stocks that interest them. So if you've got a ticker you'd like us to take a look at, stop on in. We'll look at the charts, the news, the financials, and we'll give you our opinion, whatever that's worth to you. 4 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, any Thursday you choose. We'll be there. Hope you will too. Now, in all of our shows, we've got the same focus. We're looking at OTC and penny stocks. We're looking for stocks that have potential to make us money. Now, when I first started this show, my primary focus was on the news. I was using that as our primary catalyst. Not anymore. I am now using the charts. I'm looking for chart setups, charts that have heat. Then I go looking for lingering news, something that they talked about maybe a month ago that's going to happen 3 weeks from now. Right, perfect timing to get into something. So those are the type of stocks we're looking at. And all of them are penny stocks. Now, that's not to say they're all on the OTC market. What I'm saying is all of them are under $5. A penny stock isn't about what market it's on, it's only about price. As long as they're under $5, they are penny stocks. Now, I like to trade the stocks on the major exchanges. There's lots of benefits there, but I also like to trade the OTC stocks. They're super cheap, lots of startup companies, new technology. Bottom line is just a lot of opportunities to make some money down there. So I do a lot of research on the OTC markets. And most of that research comes from this site right here. All that news came from this site. Not one piece of news came from anywhere else. That's about 8 days worth of news. Oldest is up at the top, newest is down at the bottom. That's news I've read. That is prime news, good news, and I got it all right here. I also get my financials, my filings, my share structure, all here. And I trust it because it's updated every single day by FINRA and the SEC. Where else am I going to go for information? I want milk. I don't go to the dishwasher. I go to the refrigerator. This is where the milk is at, right here. So I am not going out to the internet to do my research unless I can't find what I'm looking for. But most of the time, I do. All right, let's take a look at how our OTC market finished today. Ooh, that's not looking very good. Fingers crossed. So much for crossing your fingers. Everything is down today, folks. And what's most concerning is our trades. You hear me say all the time, we're stuck between 250 and 300,000 trades. Well, we've been there maybe 6 months now. So to see her breaking out the wrong direction is not encouraging at all. We have been down under 250,000 trades now for 2 days in a row. Our share volume, we can't get it near 10 billion. We keep bouncing between 4 billion and 7 billion. We're right there. And our dollar volume is staying down low. I think we are at 1.3 billion the other day. We're at 1.4 billion today. That is pathetic, folks. Thank God, though, we don't have to settle for the sentiment of the market. We can go out hunting for individual stocks that can bring us some joy. And I think I found some. You interested? Come on, I'll show you what I got. First yummy gummy I'm going to give you to chew on is ticker SMGI. This is SMG Industries. Now, I did find this by going through the charts, looking for charts that have heat, setups for a breakout. This one looked good. So I came over here looking for some lingering news, going through her filings and her press releases. I couldn't find any lingering news. Now, it's not that she hasn't got any news. She's got lots of news, but nothing about contracts or who they're doing business with or where they're doing business. All of their news presses are about their financials, 100% of them. And still, I believe I've got enough information to believe that this chart is going to move. So SMGI, she finished the day at 22 cents with 10% gains. On the middle tier of the OTC, the better tier, the QB, it's better because you have to audit your financials to be here. That just makes them more transparent, more trustworthy. They've got all the green ticks we're looking for. Transfer agent verified, verified profile. They've got independent directors. Now, you got to have these if you're going to uplist, no doubt about that. But they may have already used them to go from the pink to the QB. But what do I know? They may have aspirations to get to the NASDAQ. They would need them then too. And they are penny stock exempt. which means they're not as risky as, say, a startup company. They've proven their reliability by being in business for 3 to 5 years and having millions of dollars of assets during that entire period and maintaining their financial filings. So everything looks really, really good here. So what sort of business is this company in? Heavy freight hauling. That's what I can tell you. If it's big, they'll move it. Through several of the company's wholly owned subsidiaries branded as 5J Transportation Group, it offers specialized heavy haul, super heavy haul, flatbed, brokerage, and drilling rig mobilization services. 5J's engineered permitted jobs can support up to 500,000-pound loads, including infrastructure cargo associated with wind energy, power generation components, bridge beams, compressors, and refinery construction equipment. SMG Industries is headquartered in Houston, Texas. They've got a lot of other offices in Texas, and they've got one in South Carolina as well. So what was her relative volume today, considering she hasn't got any real catalyst? Well, she did jump 50%. Well, she did. It went from the under the radar 8.2 thousand to still under the radar 12.3 thousand. So we got a lot of growth here. Nobody's really looking at this stock. It's kind of hard to notice a stock if they don't put out a news press, isn't it? Share structure. What do we got here? Unrestricted shares, they tell us there are 46 million. They say the float has 6.7 million. So I went searching, did a Google search, and this is what I found. Only two numbers. 10.3 million, and then down here I found 11.8 million. And just going on and on, there's no other numbers to choose from. Those are the only two numbers. So bottom line, we've got ourselves a low float. Outstanding is 48 million. We've got between 10 and 11. Not bad. Financials. Well, this is where she shines bright. Look at how she is jumping in her revenues, folks. 2019, she was at $500,000. 1 year later, she's at $26.5 million. A year later, she's at $52 million. And 2022, they haven't actually brought it out, but they talk about it, and this is what they said. 2022, they earned $71 million. So there you go. $500,000, 26, 52, 71. They're just doing more and more business. This company is all about moving that heavy stuff. And right now, they're making most of their money moving oil rigs and huge beams for bridges, infrastructure. They're doing a lot of other stuff, but that's their primary money makers right now. At least that's what it says in their financials. Taking a look at their disclosures. All right, we've got one 8K here that came out at the end of January. That is about their financials. And then we've got four Form 4s here. That's almost a tongue twister. Now, a Form 4 is a filing that has to be put out when a insider, the management, buys or sells shares of stock. Well, that's not exactly true. It's just acquiring or losing the shares. They might buy them, but they can get them by other means. This is Madden Steven, Chief Transition Officer, and they have gotten a ton of shares here. As you can see, they got 3,700,000 and 549,000, and they got all those on January 27th. But what needs to be noted is they did not buy them. Look at the price. There is no price. There's only a notation to a footnote, and that footnote tells us the reason they got those shares. Issued as consideration for the extension of the maturity date of certain loans to the issuer, or issued as additional consideration in connection with the loans made to the issuer. I'll be honest, I don't know the specifics, but what I can tell you is none of these are being bought. All Form 4s here, all of them, these are shares being given for one reason or another, but nobody's bought any. All right, and the news. Well, as I said, they've got news, it's just not anything we're particularly looking for. Everything has to do with their financials. And it is those financials that I believe are gonna move the charts. We're just waiting for that financial to come out. They have talked about it, but they haven't actually come out with the filing yet. And I think when the filing comes out, this chart's gonna run. Let's go take a look at it. You know exactly where we're at. This is Thinkorswim, the free trading platform you get just for signing up for that free trading account with TD Ameritrade. So we are looking at ticker SMGI. This is a 6-month, 4-hour chart. Today, we hit our high of 22 cents. And January 10th, we hit our low of 10.5 cents. Between the two, you've got over 100% gains. She has been under the 200 all this time and following the 50-day SMA for about 4 or 5 months until she had this big drop. And she quickly jumped right back up to that 50-day SMA and wasn't done. She kept pushing and has got herself over that 200-day SMA, finishing on a high today. Nothing really to talk about in the volume, but the oscillators are kicking butt. This is our 4-hour chart. We have our RSI up at 62. MACD is screaming up, getting stronger. Same thing with our PPO. These two are much alike. The PPO and the MACD, they're akin to each other. Read them the same way. Everything looks superb on the 4-hour. Looking at our 1-hour 20-day. Not a lot going on back here. We had that big fall. She jumped right back into line. And for the last 5 or 6 days, she's been climbing on top of her 9-day SMA. Light as helium and rising fast. Technicals are excellent. Look at every single one of them are pushing up right now, folks. Doesn't matter where they are. If all of your oscillators are pointing up, you're in a winning position. Our 5-day, 5-minute. Looking just as good as the hourly, we are riding up on our 9-day SMA, not coming below it, light as a feather. Hit our high early in the morning and pretty much held that all day long. And look at our oscillators, our technicals, all up, all of them. 4-hour, 1-hour, 5-minute, all the oscillators look great. Folks, this looks good. Even though we don't have a direct catalyst, I'm presuming as soon as that financial comes out, this thing is going to rip. That's my opinion. SMGI, it belongs on your watch list before those financials come out. The next yummy gummy I got for you comes off the NASDAQ. This is Reborn Coffee, ticker REBN. And of course, I found this the same way I'm finding all of the stocks. Warm charts. And once I found that chart, I came over here looking for lingering news. No luck there. All they've got is current news, and it's pretty hot. What I discovered is that this is a startup company, and they are spreading their wings globally right now, and the revenues are starting to accumulate. And those are always good catalysts, especially if you've got a warm chart. So REBN finished the day at $1.04 with about 2.5% gains. Now we're going to bypass this little description and look at a bigger one in a news press. They tell us here that Reborn Coffee is focused on serving high-quality specialty roasted coffee at retail locations, kiosks, and cafes. Reborn is an innovative company that strives for constant improvement in the coffee experience through exploration of new technology and premier service, guided by traditional brewing techniques. Reborn believes they differentiate themselves from other coffee roasters through innovative techniques, including sourcing, washing, roasting, and brewing their coffee beans with a balance of precision and craft. So what was this company's relative volume today without any direct catalyst, actually? Not good. Maybe she needs that direct catalyst. She dropped over 60% of her daily average, going from 110,000 down to 31,000 shares. Definitely under the radar. Share structure for REBN. Well, I can tell you this much. We've got a low float. Outstanding shares, that is 11.6 million. So to find out, I had to run over to Google and do this. And I got a lot of different numbers here, folks. See, I put in the company's name, the ticker, and then I put float outstanding. Putting in the outstanding seems to draw the word float up more often. And this is what I found. I am looking for numbers that agree with each other. Well, here's two. 4.28 million. Well, looking for other numbers, I found 12,800. That's what that K stands for, 1,000. And then further down, I found another one, 2.8 million. So which one am I to choose? Which one is the actual float? I honestly don't know. I always go by default, whichever numbers agree. But that doesn't guarantee anything. So I'm presuming we got 4.2 million shares in the float, which would be a great float. If it turns out to be 2 million or 12,000, better yet. Financials, well, this is where it gets nice. Their revenues are starting to pick up. 2019, they were at $617,000. We got three zeros here we got to put behind any of the numbers. $150,000 was added in 2020. And then they took a huge jump. 2021, they went to $2.2 million, getting to keep $1.4 million of that. Looking at the quarterly to get some 2022 figures. Well, we're missing one here. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if they missed it or if the OTC market missed it, but we're missing the first quarter of 2022. Second and third quarter, they're doing about $800,000 each quarter. So that's $1.6 million just in two quarters. Their revenues are growing, folks. And let's take a look at their disclosures. What do we got over here? We got one 8K, that's recent, that came out just about a month ago. I did take a peek at this. This has to do with election of directors. And then all the other filings here are just too far back to consider. Taking a look at our news. All right, we've got news here going back to December. We got three pieces of news here that are interesting. One that came out the first week of December, Reborn Coffee expands to South Korea with acquisition of specialty coffee shop and roasting R&D facility in Daejeon. Then here at the beginning of January, Reborn Coffee adds retail locations in California and Korea. And then we had one on the 19th of January. Reborn Coffee partners with Collective to expand brand into Malaysia and Indonesia. And that's really all that's going on. There's not a whole lot that you can actually get from the news. They're just talking about these locations. Right now, they've got 14 cafes open, 14 coffee shops, whatever you want to call them. And that's the sort of money they're generating with 14. And they're trying to open them up as fast as they possibly can. So I expect the revenues to continue growing. Coffee seems to be a big thing, and we're willing to pay $6 a cup for it. Are they in Indonesia too? I don't know. All right, let's go take a look at this chart. Ooh, it's an ugly chart, isn't it? I agree. This is ticker REBN, 6-month, 4-hour chart. We got a high back here 6 months ago at $12.45 in a huge fall all the way down to 73 cents at the beginning of January. We see our 200-day SMA has just come into the picture, and she started to jump towards it once it got close. But when you see your 200-day coming downhill, don't expect the breakthrough to actually climb. You need to get these 200s flat or climbing up before the price wants to stay above it. And that's exactly what's happened here. She hit this low bubble. She pushed off of it, got over a 50-day, kept on pushing, got over a 200-day, rolled back down, but did not come under the 200. Bounced here, and is sitting up there right now. Looking good, but not strong. We have no volume to talk about, and our technicals look pretty weak right now. Everything is on the downside and pushing down very lightly. 20-day, 1-hour view. We got the same thing going on here. She's crossed the 200-day SMA, pushed up hard, then rolled back down, but she's bouncing off of the 200-day SMA. And right now she is negotiating with it, looking like she's losing the battle, but she may do just what she's done here, come under and back up. Technicals aren't showing a whole lot of enthusiasm. Everything is still pushing down on the 1-hour chart. 5-minute, 5-day chart. She's doing the same thing on the 5-minute. She is wrestling that 200. She does not want to stay down, but she can't get enough strength to go up. She really needs to get some volume. So right now she's going sideways on that 200. The 200 is starting to turn now. Just lightly, it's starting to turn, which can help the price move. But as you can see by our technicals, everything is pushing down right now. She could come further. You can see if I grab my support line here, you can see we've got some lows here. That's a common one, right? It hit here, hit here, hit here, hit here, hit here. So it could come all the way down here to $1, which obviously probably would be a good buy-in price, because every time she hits it, she bounces back real quick. She does not stay down there very long. So watch this. If she comes down to this price down here, you could pick it up at $1, and she'd jump back probably up here to the $6, $7 area. And then when that financial comes out, I'm believing it's going to push this chart up. REBN. For a swing hold for maybe 10 days, it's hard to tell when that financial is coming out. Aw, you've been so patient waiting for me to talk about a warrant attached to a SPAC. I've got one for you. I just wish I'd have shared this with you yesterday when I posted the news. She's already at a nice bump, but don't you worry none. There are lots of gains still sitting on the table. So we are looking at the SPAC Cascadia Acquisition Corp. Ticker for the warrant is CCAIW. She finished the day at 14 cents with just a little over 40% gains. Now, as most warrants are, she's on the major exchange on the NASDAQ, so we can trade this pre-market after market. So what was the relative volume around the warrant today? Ooh, nice. She jumped from 18,000 to 89,000. No, that is not under the radar. 89,000 shares of warrants sold in a day is pretty good. Share structure, we don't have to look at it. There is none for warrants. Financials, they're not making money yet, and there are no disclosures. This is real simple. All we got is one piece of news. Now, this news came out, it was either yesterday or the day before. I can't actually remember, and they don't put the date on this piece of news, so I'm not real sure, but it is real recent. They tell us here that RealWear Inc. has entered into an agreement to become a publicly traded company via a business combination transaction with Cascadia Acquisition Corp. RealWear Inc., a leading industrial wearable technology solution company, and Cascadia Acquisition Corp. have entered into that definitive business combination agreement. Upon closing of the transaction, the combined company will be named RealWear Inc. RealWear provides wearable assisted reality solutions to frontline professionals to engage, empower, and elevate the modern industrial worker to be more efficient and perform work tasks more safely and with more precision. The company's assisted reality tools enable frontline professionals to view, communicate, and share documents, diagrams, photos, and video, all while keeping their hands and field of view free for work. The transaction will require the approval of the shareholders of both RealWear and CCAI. The combined company is expected to have a post-transaction enterprise value of $375 million. And I don't believe they have a date here either. So you've got a company here that is about ready to go public, and they've got this fancy gear that allows you to talk to people and see the diagrams, the videos, the photos, whatever you need to see that's right in front of you. You got it all right there. So I think this is a new technology that could be very hot. It is a SPAC that is merging with this company, and this is the first piece of news. Always expect a bounce on the first piece of news, but there's a progress. They've still got to sign the letter, if they've even gotten that close. Every piece of news before they close the deal is going to have the warrant bouncing. That's why we're looking at it. Let's go take a look at the chart. That's not a bad looking chart. This is ticker CCAIW, the warrant for Cascadia Acquisition. We got a 6 month, 4 hour chart here. We got a high back here in July of about 34 cents, and we hit a low here at the beginning of January. Ooh, 0002. And right now we're at 14 cents. What a climb that was. And you can see I was looking at this a while ago, maybe 4 or 5 days ago. I was thinking about showing this one to you because it looked like she was ready for a breakout. I should have showed it to you, right? She did have a breakout. She jumped here from 3.2 cents all the way up to 15 cents. You're looking at a 400-500% run right there. She came back down and she's sitting right on top of her 9-day SMA, ready to go through that 200. She's already tested it once, twice, and thrice. That is the magic number. We got lots of volume that is coming in right now, and all of our technicals are on fire. All of them are pushing up. It looks great on the 4-hour chart. 20-day, 1-hour view. So there's that breakout. Wish I would have told you about it then. She had that 400-500% run, fell back down, and is starting to climb again on her 9-day SMA. When the price gets too far away from that 9-day, it will come back to it, folks. You've got to expect it, and it's going to happen in a quick hurry. And that is exactly what happened there. And right now, she is sitting on her 9-day perfectly, looking like she's ready to climb. Our technicals, our PPO is very strong. MACD has just had a crossover and starting to show strength. Our ADX is going down, and our PPO is going up. Whenever you see that blue line up and the red line down, it means the price is climbing. It's guaranteed. So right now, everything is looking good. The only thing I see here is that our RSI is starting to dip a little bit. though it sure doesn't show on the chart. Maybe we'll see it on the 5-day, 5-minute. Not really. I do see a drop there, but that was showing it at the end of the day. All right, so we had that huge jump right here. She came back down to the 9-day, had a break through that 9-day, even through her 50, but pushed herself right back up. There's that steady foot, dropped it onto that 50-day SMA before she launched herself. She had a nice high here, pulled back right at the 50% mark. This is looking really nice, folks. Our technicals, PPO is pushing up, MACD is climbing. That RSI is falling again. Well, I guess we did have a fall there. It just isn't red, it's green. So it doesn't stand out as a fall. I like this chart, CCAIW. I wish I would have showed this to you sooner, but now is not a bad time. She is ready to break out, folks. You can get some money on this. There's a lot of progress still to go. CCAIW, it belongs on your watch list. May even want to consider a position tomorrow. You may want to get yourself a starter position. If she dips, you can get yourself some more. If she starts to take off, I don't know if you'll be able to buy any more the way these warrants move. In either case, I'm only putting in $50 into each of my warrants. That's all I'm doing because, like I said, these warrants don't get a lot of volume. Why should I buy 20,000 shares if they're doing 5 or 10,000 shares a day? I'm not getting greedy. I'm just trying to make my money, double it, quadruple it, 10 times it, and then take my winnings and buy more SPACs, and then try to make my big money off of a number of SPACs doing what this one is gonna do. You like that idea? I sure hope that you're starting to do DD the way I'm doing it. I mean, you can keep following the news if you like, but I don't find that very dependable or reliable. 10 pieces of news come out, all hot. We're lucky if 3 stocks run. But when you find 10 charts that are hot, that are breaking out over SMAs, that are breaking out of channels, that have a lot of volume, we're getting 6 or 7 of those taking off. Maybe not the very next day, but in a very short amount of time. It seems to me the charts take precedent over the news. But you'll figure that out doing DD. It's worth it, folks. The more you know, the more you're going to grow. See ya.